Let's all play What's My Line? And now, let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, a comedian who has appeared in movies, on stage, on television, and supper clubs throughout the nation, Soupy Sales.
Thank you. There are a lot of famous show business families. The Booths, the Barrymores, the Redgraves, and the Fondas. And here's the most beautiful of the new group. This is Meredith MacRae.
Thank you. Our next panelist not only has his own daytime television show Match Game, but he also has a great-looking tie on today. Gene Rayburn.
Thank you. Now it's my pleasure to present to you a most chic, attractive lady, someone well known to you, Miss Arlene Francis.
You know, the old What's My Line panel used to think how lucky we were to have a man of such wisdom as John Daly hold us together. Well, the new What's My Line is very lucky, too, because we have a man of grace and perception in the form of Wally Bruner.
And thank you, Arlene.
Oh, you're very welcome.
A good-looking panel we have. And welcome, everyone, to What's My Line. You know, during the next 30 minutes, you're going to meet some interesting people engaged in occupations which we hope will baffle our panel. And then later on, the panel is going to face a mystery celebrity guest, and we hope that the mystery celebrity guest will stump them too. So that's the lineup that we have for you, and I'm sure you're going to have a good time. So, panel, are you all set and all ready?
Ready, ready, ready.
Okay, let's meet the first challenger. Will you come in and sign in, please?
Whoa.
Leatherman?
I'm in love already.
Miss? X. Panel, we're going to refer to this young lady as Miss X because we're afraid if we gave you her name, it might also give away her occupation. So we certainly wouldn't want to do that. Do you know how to play the game, Miss X?
Yes, I do.
Well, let's refresh the memory of the audience and our studio audience as well. Remember, for every no answer that Miss X is able to give the panel, she earns $5. And 10 no answers means she stumped the panel and won the game. And now I'd like to tell the panel just exactly what Miss X does to a certain extent. She's self-employed and deals in a service. And we're going to begin the questioning with Gene Rayburn.
Don't you want to tell the audience?
Yeah, let's tell the audience at home what she does.
Oh, that's an excellent suggestion. Let's let everyone in the audience know exactly what her occupation is. There we go. Now we're all set, Gene.
Okay, now
Take it away.
You are self-employed. Is it a physical activity that you're engaged in?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And do you wear a certain costume or uniform?
Yes.
Is it in the general field of entertainment?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it something that might go on here in New York?
Yes.
Could I do it with you?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Would you like to meet me after the show?
Yes.
Would I?
Well,
I'll just give her the $50 and let's get out of here.
Flip all the cards.
Would it be a pleasurable experience?
Yes.
You do your show, sir, and I'll do mine. Would it be remunerative for you?
Yes, I would think you.
What does remunerative mean?
I mean, I think that there is some compensation due you for performing her particular service. So yes, it would be of profit to our young lady.
Would it change my physical appearance in any way?
It could.
I think, though, generally speaking, it probably really, him partaking of the service that you dispense of would not really change his physical appearance. So let's give him a no on that, and you're one ahead and go on to Arlene.
Is it a good idea to have music playing when you're doing this with Gene?
Yes.
You bet.
Does dancing come into it in any way?
Yes.
Yes.
Are you a go-go dancer of some kind, or a belly dancer, or... No.
Yes.
A belly dancer. Oh. Let me tell you, and Miss X is not just any regular belly dancer. Miss X is probably the best known, foremost belly dancer anywhere. This is Little Egypt. But to go even one step further, it is not just Little Egypt, but she is the granddaughter?
The
great-granddaughter of the original Little Egypt, who performed at the Chicago World's Fair in 1893.
Right.
How about that?
Listen, you can dance on my belly anytime.
Well, you've been performing
Isn't that what they do?
A long time. How long?
Oh, yes. Well, I've been performing since I was 5 years old, but in the American nightclubs, I'd say about 6.5 years.
Does this pay very well?
Extremely, for me, yes.
Questions?
Yes, are we going to have a little...
Later in the show, we're going to have a complete demonstration. Little Egypt is going to come back and give us a really good example of what a belly dancer does today.
Right.
Little Egypt, you're marvelous, I'm sorry. I think we should just flip all the cards for her.
Sure.
It's good some Todman's money and,
okay,
you know...
Yeah.
So we're going to give you $50 and thank you so much
thank
for being
you
with
very
us.
Much,
Very well done, panel. Very
she
well
went
done.
Went out the wrong way. Should I go get her?
She'll be back. I promise you, Gene, she'll be back. You have not seen the last of Little Egypt. And we're going to meet our next challenger in just a moment. Okay, panel, if we're all set, and you did marvelously well on the first challenger today, now will the next challenger please enter and sign in? The Reverend Dale Lind. Well, panel, as you can tell, our challenger is actually the Reverend Dale Lind. He is an ordained minister until just recently was the assistant pastor of St. Peter's Lutheran Church in New York. And you're now working on a master's degree, I believe.
That's correct.
And that's at the New York Theological Seminary. But he's engaged in an occupation while he's attending school that we think it might be a bit interesting for you to try to ferret out. You do know how to play the game.
Yes,
right,
I
Pastor?
Do.
Okay, so let's let everyone in the audience know exactly what you do for a living. Panel, I'll tell you that Pastor Len is salaried and deals in a service, and we'll begin with Arlene.
How do you do, Reverend Len?
Hello.
Has anyone ever called you a swinging minister?
Yes.
There are many people of the cloth that are very interested in music, new music. Are you?
Yes, I am.
But I do believe that whether he may have an interest in new music, I think that would lead you up the wrong path because...
But I just was socializing with him.
Oh.
Can't blame a girl for that.
Social, all right. One socializing question, but Arlene. Mm.
Yes, I really should let it go because my mind was on music and obviously what you do has nothing to do with music. Is that correct?
Yes.
So I'll pass it on as long as that was really what I was thinking of.
That was really what you're thinking. Okay, so we're going to give you the one down and go on to Soupy. Soupy? Because really, I should have given you a no, Arlene.
You guys are the guys that originated turtlenecks. Wouldn't it be funny if that's what he did? He made turtlenecks. Well, then it's something that you do is concerned with entertainment.
Entertainment?
No.
No. So that's two down. We go to Meredith MacRae.
Does what you do involve teaching in any way? Do you teach something?
No.
No. Three down. Gene Rayburn.
Is this a full-time job?
Yes.
And are people's lives benefited by it in any way?
Perhaps.
Yes.
Yes. All sexes involved in this?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Families?
I would think we're going to have to give you a no. No, not families, Gene. So that's four down, and we go to Arlene.
Do you move around from place to place in your job?
No.
No. Five down, Soupy Sales.
If I had this, is it something that I might come to you?
Yes.
Yes.
If I came to you with this problem, would I have a problem?
Perhaps.
Possibly, yes. Possibly.
Yeah, perhaps. You might, but I don't really know that if, you know. But well, well, go ahead.
I mean, by the service that you deal in, Reverend, is it something that, say, if I came to you over a period of time, it might change my outlook and...
Very well could.
You think it really?
Yeah.
Oh, I think, though, in the nature of the questioning, we're almost going to... He really wouldn't change his physical appearance, though.
No, not physical. I mean the way that I felt toward this particular problem, if I had it.
Yes, it might well affect the way you felt, so I will let you continue.
When a person finishes coming to you, are they liable not to bother with a particular, say, vice that they had been involved in before?
Does he give advice to
no,
the people?
No, a certain vice, which takes in gambling or drinking and wild, wild women.
There may be a certain vice connected with what he does.
Oh, yeah? Oh, I'm getting hot. Let's see. And these lights are helping. Is it something that, say, do you deal, say, with alcoholics?
Sometimes?
Sometimes.
Oh. He deals with alcoholics sometimes. I deal with it quite a bit myself. I pass.
Okay,
right.
Meredith.
Are you at all involved in any form of gambling or card playing?
No.
No. Six down, Gene Rayburn.
Do you work with young people, teenagers?
Alcoholic teenagers?
No.
No.
Seven down and Arlene.
Does psychology have anything to do with your job, Reverend Lynn?
Not in the sense I think Arlene is directing. As psychology may well have something to do with just about any endeavor in which you would care to partake, I don't think in this particular field it would have anything more to do with it than anything else, so we'll say
Thank
no.
Thank you, John.
Eight down, and we'll go to Soupy Sales.
Well, do you have anything to do with Alcoholics Anonymous?
No.
No. Nine down.
When you perform your service, do you touch the person in any way? Do you come in contact physically with the person?
No.
No. That's ten down. Panel, our contestant has won the game. And I want the pastor to tell you exactly what he does. Would you please?
Yes, I'm a bartender, Miss Lacey Sutherland.
I want you to know that Pastor Lynn works at Miss Lacey's here in New York as a bartender. He's been there the past 7 months. You're a graduate of the International Bartending School here in New York City.
Yes.
Isn't that right?
I hope it's a milk bar.
No, it's a regular bartender. And
what do you wear?
Oh, I wear a regular suit, sometimes a jacket.
You don't wear the collar, of course.
No, I do not.
No.
How does your congregation... I mean, how do they look upon this? Are they rather broad-minded and liberal about their pastor?
Yes. Well, I'm not technically serving a particular congregation at this moment. I preach in various congregations on Sundays who do not have a pastor, or the pastor may be sick or on vacation. But I have classes at the New York Seminary and support myself by attending bar and feel that this is a way of relating to people and
it's
a
the best
good form
relationship
of
you can have, straightening them out at the bar.
I imagine you meet quite a few people at work that you wouldn't ordinarily meet at work.
Oh, that's true. And they're very beautiful people, and I enjoy it very much.
Well, Reverend Lynn, you've won $50, and it's been a lot of fun having you on What's My Line. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we'll be back to meet our mystery guest as What's My Line continues. It's now mystery guest time on What's My Line, and panel, are the blindfolds in place?
Right, yes. Now, yes.
Okay, so mystery challenger, would you come in and sign in, please? Okay, panel, now, as you know, it's one question at a time, and I'm going to give you exactly 3 minutes to establish the identity of our very famous mystery guest. And let's begin the questioning with Meredith MacRae.
Are you in the entertainment business?
Ah, boy, pants.
That's a yes. Gene.
Are you an actor?
Ah, boy.
Yes.
Are you also a singer?
Ah, boy.
Yes. Soupy.
Are you currently, starring, say, on your own television show?
No.
Are you my father?
Yes! How did she guess that? Oh, God. You lose. How about that?
I have to say, Wally, I have to say how I guessed that. My dad, when I was little, used to always be doing those Donald Duck things. And now, Daddy has a new little baby. I have a new little sister named Amanda, and he's always doing that with her. And I was over there the other day with him, and that's what made me think about it.
Well, that's why I picked it, because I didn't think I knew you'd recognize my voice.
So. I know I would. That's great, though.
Well, I'll be doggone.
I can tell you're the only person in the world that could do Donald Duck that way.
No, Richie Little can do it.
Amanda's now, what, 2 months old?
Amanda's 2 months old. And how are you, Wally? I've been watching the show, and you're very fine on the show.
Oh, thank you. And we enjoy Meredith so much, too.
I
want to
wish you a lot of success. I'm very proud of Meredith, naturally. All my children.
Well, you have another daughter in show business, Heather.
Yes, little Heather's in some kind of show business. I don't know. She just made a picture. I don't know the name of it. A real off-Broadway picture. She was on a show here in New York very briefly called Here's Where I Belong. But she also has talent like Meredith does.
What kind of advice do you give your daughters, Gordon? Here they're launching careers, and Meredith is
Yeah, what advice do you have for this girl right now? What would you tell her to do?
Well, Wally, we never gave them advice. You know, I always tell a cute story on Meredith. When she first got into television on My Three Sons, Don Fettes and the producer and I were playing golf about 6 weeks after Meredith had started taping the show. And he said, Gordon MacRae, do you have a daughter named Meredith MacRae? I said, yes, I do. He said, well, she's on my show. I said, yes, I know. And he said, she never told me that you were her father. So
they
did it on their own.
They did it on their own.
You know, I don't believe parents should tell children what to do. Like if you're a lawyer or a doctor, they don't necessarily have to be doctors or actors. Children shouldn't necessarily have to be actors or actresses. So we let them sort of go out on their own. Didn't we, dear?
Yes, I think that neither my mother or my dad encouraged me to go into show business at all. They would much have preferred me to be an English teacher or something.
No.
But now you're glad I'm in it.
Well, let me tell you this, Gordon. I think you're very, very lucky to have a daughter like Meredith. But also, I think Meredith is very lucky to have a father like you.
Well, thank you very much,
Gordon MacRae. Thank you so much for being with us.
All right.
I have just learned something very interesting. We now have a yachtsman among our panelists, Gene Rayburn.
Yeah, I'm a sailor. I lived in a suburb of New York for a long time where they had yacht races and all kinds of sailboat races. And I lived near Long Island Sound, never got interested in sailing because it always seemed dull to me. And then 3 or 4 years ago, I bought a house up in Cape Cod and bought a little 13-foot fiberglass catamaran, and I am now the most devoted sailor, because it's so much fun. It really is. You know, I finally understand the challenge of man against the winds and nature and all that. And
yeah, Gene was in a yacht race the other day. He chased his girl around the deck for about 3 hours.
Well, you also flew your own plane.
Yeah, I had an airplane at one time. That's a lot of fun, too, but there really aren't enough flying days in the eastern part of the country to continue that as a hobby, so I dropped that.
Well, Gene, we feel very, very fortunate in having you as among our panel this week on What's My Line. You've done a remarkable job. Thank you so much for
being here. Thank you, Wally. It's a pleasure to be here.
All right, now it's time to make good on a promise.
Yeah.
And here is Little Egypt, our belly dancer. Little Egypt.
Yeah, go.
I think we all need to take a closer look. Come on up and join us, panel, and let's belly dance our way out. Okay? Can you teach them the steps? Okay. Goodbye, everyone. We'll see you again tomorrow on What's My Line.
What's My Line is a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. This is Johnny Olson speaking.